Lily come back. New COVID treatment works against Omicron. Eli Lilly is back in the fight against COVID-19. Its new monoclonal antibody therapy showed impressive performance versus Omicron. With that, the US FDA granted it emergency use authorization. Monoclonal antibodies are treatments designed to prevent or reduce the chances of hospitalization. These are antibodies similar to the ones produced by our bodies, except mass-produced in the lab to treat numerous patients. The goal is the same: target a specific part of the virus to stop it from causing more damage. Although they can be effective, these are not replacements for vaccination. Months ago, pharmaceutical company Eli Lilly created the monoclonal antibody combination bamlanivimab and etesevimab. But its EUA was revoked by the US FDA because of the Omicron variant. On January 24, the agency revoked authorization after data showed that it's high unlikely to be active against the variant. Since Omicron is the dominant variant, the therapy will more or less do nothing until it is improved. However, less than a month later, the company received EUA for its new monoclonal antibody therapy. Unlike its predecessor, bebtelovimab showed a powerful impact against Omicron. Based on Phase 2 Blade 4 trial, bebtelovimab demonstrated full neutralizing activity against the variant in pseudovirus and authentic virus. In short, the new therapy wasn't hindered by Omicron compared to the other two drugs mentioned. Lilly is pleased to provide another treatment option to help address the ongoing needs of patients and healthcare providers who continue to battle this pandemic, said President of Lilly Research Laboratories Dr. Daniel Skovronsky. With EUA, Lilly's bebtelovimab can now be used as a treatment for mild to moderate COVID-19 among adults and children aged 12 years weighing at least 40 kilograms. The patient must be laboratory positive for COVID and deemed at a high risk of severe symptoms, hospitalization, or death, where other approved options are inaccessible or clinically inappropriate. Its use for hospitalized COVID patients isn't authorized at this time. This is because its effects on this setting aren't yet studied. That said, no one can tell what may happen to a hospitalized patient. They may worsen if they receive this monoclonal therapy while under supplemental oxygen. For adverse events, the drug may trigger allergic reactions, including anaphylaxis. Such reactions are monitored 24 hours after infusion. Other adverse reactions include rash, itching, nausea, and vomiting. For pregnancy and breastfeeding, there's no way to tell what effects the drug may have, so it is best to avoid using it to prevent unwanted events. Lilly has signed an agreement with the US government to supply up to 600,000 doses of the new monoclonal antibody. What do you think of Lilly's comeback? Will this one work consistently in the real world? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.